just a quick update. Good news. So if you watched the last video, which I'll put a link in the description for that, we had had our two bluebird houses, and then we had bluebird successfully fledge out of one. When they went to do their second nest, the house sparrows came in, and the male house sparrow killed our male bluebird when he was trying to reclaim the box. So we had to trap the house sparrow, and I go into the other video about, you know, methods of house sparrow control and other things we were doing. So you can watch that one if you're interested in that. But it does show that it's successful. So the things we did worked. We do have bluebirds again now in that box. We have a successful nest. They've laid their eggs, so I'll take you out to show you that. And then also we now have a sparrow spooker on the bluebird box with the eggs, which I didn't talk about that, I don't think, in house sparrow control methods, the last video, but you only use a sparrow spooker when you already have bluebird nest or bluebird eggs in the nest. So I'll show you that. But I'm just happy that our bluebirds came back, because I really thought that it would probably be until next season when we would have bluebirds again, since our male was killed. And I don't know if it's the same female we had previously that has found a new male since her mate was killed, or if it's a whole new pair of bluebirds. It's kind of hard to tell. So, but I will take you out and see. I don't know if the female is in the box. I try to make noise when I'm coming up so that she can fly if she wants to. So, see Mama Bluebird. Yep, and there she goes, out into the fence line. Sorry, my camera doesn't have a very good zoom, but she was incubating the eggs, so I'll try to make this quick, not to stress her out too much, but they do get used to us checking daily, and they kind of realize that every time they come back to the box, nothing's amiss or damaged. So I think eventually they figure out, you know, you're not here to hurt them, you're just, for whatever reason, bothering them every day. This is the sparrow spooker design that we use. This was a pre-made one that we purchased, but you can make one yourself. Basically, just the whole idea is that it's going to be something that hangs streamers or, you know, moving paper or something over the box. For whatever reason, house sparrows are afraid of this. They do not want to enter the box when this is on top, while bluebirds typically are not afraid of it. But what you do is you don't put it until the bluebirds at least lay their first egg, because that shows you they have really claimed the box. You don't want to potentially frighten the bluebirds away from the box before they've put their eggs. But once they have their eggs, they're typically not going to abandon them. And they don't start incubating their eggs until all of them are laid. So by doing it after the first egg, you're not interrupting incubation. She still has time to finish laying the rest of her eggs. And as long as you do see another egg each day, which typically that's what they do, they lay an egg each day until they reach the final amount that they want, you'll know that you have not disturbed them. And the reason you don't keep it up the whole time is that sparrows eventually would get used to it if it was there all the time. So basically you just put it up after the first bluebird egg is laid, make sure she keeps laying eggs so you know that she's not afraid of it, which typically the bluebirds are not, and then you take it down after the baby's fledged, again so that sparrows won't get used to it just being there all the time. Here is our bluebird nest, and you can see the eggs in there. I know it's hard on this plexiglass slide. It's the sun reflects on it, and I talk about that in my other video too, about nest box reviews, why this one's a little bit harder to get pictures. It's true, I could just open the other side, but I don't really like to do that. I always feel like the nest might fall out, or if there's babies, they might fall out. But that is our bluebird nest. So we'll keep monitoring this, and I'll provide updates as the babies hatch and grow. Thanks for watching.